What is a relationship without attraction? I'm here today to speak about relationships and ropes. Ropes as in Japanese bondage, also known as kinbaku, as a way to emphasize attraction. As a relationship therapist and an experienced role model, it has been interesting for me to see the overlap between the two. The more I discovered ropes, the less it made sense to me to sit around a table and talk and talk and talk with the couples. Ropes also takes communication, but the interesting part here is that the deeper you get with your partner, the stronger the nonverbal communication, and the less you need to talk. I was introduced to ropes more than a decade ago by my life partner, who I just met at the time. After having sensed and experienced the ropes for some years, I looked back and realized the impact it had had on our relationship. There's a saying that ropes never lie. Ropes forced us to be honest and open-minded in our communication, and instead of focusing on who was being right or who was being wrong, we built up strong communication and intimacy. In ropes, I'm the one being tied, and my partner is the one tying me. I can be tied, lying on the floor, or suspended in the air, in simple or complicated patterns. Always with the presence, the control, and care from my partner. Always with focus on intimacy and aesthetics to make me the most attractive. Ropes to me are, apart from being a sexual play between two like-minded grown-ups, meditative, sensual, dominant, and challenging. Mentally, emotionally, as physically. As a way to embark my ongoing journey and discover new insights of my body and my mind. Ropes offers a unique opportunity to surrender and let go of mind and thoughts, never having to consider the next step. In my day-to-day life, juggling kids, family, home and work, ropes is my free space where I can feel completely free. In ropes, we play with polarity. Polarity is the sexual attraction between the masculine essence and the feminine essence. Polarity is like a magnet. Opposites attract and equals repels. In ropes, the one tying is the masculine essence, the one in control. The one being tied is the feminine essence, letting go of control. Complete opposites, opposites attract. If you find that your partner is being too masculine or too feminine, a good consideration will be to take a step back and focus on your own process, giving them their space to develop and explore their essences. As I started sharing these tools with other role models, the reaction and the feedback was overwhelming. I was definitely not alone being fed up of having to be in control, to consider the next step, or not being able to let go of the eight-lane highway in my mind. The realization was that letting go of control and trusting your partner is not dangerous. Being constrained and not able to move is not dangerous. Being vulnerable and overwhelmed by emotions is not dangerous. In fact, it's freeing. By recognizing my feminine essence, I could define and balance my masculine essence. At the same time, my partner could own his masculinity without turning too soft or macho. Containing both essences is reinforcing. So how do you create polarity? And what do you do to maintain the mutual attraction? Thank you.